More than 20,000 children escaped Sudan's deadly second civil war by walking thousands of miles to freedom. At least 4,000 of these lost boys of Sudan eventually made it to the United States. Gair Diwani is one of them.
When the civil war came, find me there. When we have to go to Ethiopia by foot, that's the place where my journey really began, to Ethiopia in 1987.
7 years later, Diwani began high school in Des Moines, Iowa, earned a basketball scholarship, then became a fashion model and actor. His latest role...
Hey, you're
Jeremiah.
Jeremiah, right, right. Where are you going?
To my home.
Is a fictional account of the lost boy's journey, adjustment to American life, and the unique bumps on the road.
May I ask, what credential is required to drive a car?
Well, you need a driver's license. You practice, and then you pass a test. Whoa, 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 slow down, slow down, slow down. Left, left, okay. Okay, now just stop. Whoa, whoa, put the brakes! Brakes! Brakes!
Okay? Oh, I think you should just stick to walking.
We sat down with Diwani and his castmates before the Good Lies premiere.
Gair, you actually are from South Sudan. You were a child soldier. You were a refugee. How true to reality is the film?
I have so many titles under my name. Yeah. Yeah, the story is very close to me. It came right from where I'm from. And in the center of it is our life experiences as the boys who really fled the country in 1987 by foot, all the way to Ethiopia with no food to live. It was just a whole chaos was going on in 1991, where sometime I wonder if people knew about what was going on in 1991. And then here we are now, we're making movies about 1991, and the same problem is still going on.
More than 2 million have died in Sudan's civil war. It's a statistic and a story that drew Academy Award-winning actress Reese Witherspoon to the project.
You're giving me the check back in 6 months speech?
She plays a counselor, helping three lost boys find jobs in Kansas City.
Your character, if you could only describe her in one word, how would you describe her?
Feisty.
Feisty.
So I'm going to try and get you more job interviews. It's not going to be easy.
I have faith, Yardie.
Yardie?
This is a special name for you.
For me?
Yes. It had great cultural significance.
What does it mean?
It means great white cow.
Okay. Well, it's better than a lot of things I've been called.
What is it about this role that made you want to do it?
The script was beautiful. It just really told the story of the Lost Boys of Sudan in a beautiful way, the struggle of these children traveling thousands of miles across the desert just to find safety.
The film begins with a look at that harrowing escape. Sudanese children walking hundreds of miles, crossing bodies of water, braving heat exposure. And boys weren't the only ones to make the journey. Kuth Wheel makes her acting debut in this film.
We may not know the exact day we were born.
As the Lost Boy's sister, Abitel.
Brings me to you, Kuth. You actually are from Sudan. You were in a refugee camp. You lost your dad in the war in Sudan in 1993, right? I don't even know where to go. I mean, how do you act in this film knowing your personal history? I mean, all that you've endured.
I mean, for me, besides my own personal history, I felt that it brought closure. In a sense, like for everyone that had gone through this. And it's still going through it today. And it was a journey to learn about myself. It's so inspiring to see these children go through this and somehow come out of it laughing, in a sense. And I learned so much about my own history that I didn't necessarily know because I immigrated to the U.S. as a child.
With such close ties to Sudan, the Good Lies cast hopes American audiences will learn and laugh at this story, ripped from the emotional pages of real life.
I let my brother be taken away by soldiers instead of me.
Ephraim Graham, CBN News, Nashville, Tennessee.